Light has dual nature. In this topic, we are going to discuss the wave nature of light in wave optics. Let's see what are primary and secondary sources of light. Primary sources are sun, stars, objects at high temperature, effects of electric current being passed, chemical or nuclear reactions. They produce light on their own. Secondary sources like moon, planets, plants, animals. Secondary sources are extended sources. They do not produce light on their own. Let's see what is wave theory of light. Light travels in the form of longitudinal waves with uniform velocity in homogeneous medium. Different colored lights are due to different wavelengths of light. When light enters our eyes, we get the sensation of light. A material medium is required for propagation of longitudinal waves called ether. So Huygens wave theory, the light is propagated in the form of waves. The different colors of the light are due to different wavelengths of light. Velocity of light is greater in rarer medium than in denser medium. This is one of the major advantages. Foucault's experiment supported this observation. To explain propagation of light, wave theory assumed an imaginary medium called luminiferous ether present everywhere. This medium was assumed to be perfectly elastic and transparent. Wave theory could not explain the phenomenon of reflection, refraction, diffraction, interference, polarization, etc. Now let's see the limitations. All attempts like Michelson-Morley experiment to detect ether have failed. Hence, it was concluded that such medium does not exist. The rectilinear propagation of light could not be explained. Waves were assumed longitudinal, hence polarization and diffraction could not be explained. The wave theory was developed by Young and Fresnel and assumed transverse nature of light waves. Photoelectric effect, Raman effect, etc. could not be explained by this theory. Now let us see what are wavefronts and wave normals. These are the wavefronts and wave normals of diverging beam of light. It's in the three-dimensional sense. Now let's see. The wavefront is the locus of all the points of the medium to which all the waves will reach simultaneously, so that all the points are in the same state of vibration is called wavefront. The different types of wavefront are spherical wavefront, which is emerging from a point source of light at a finite distance. That is called spherical wavefront. Wavefronts in the form of spherical sphere, either complete sphere or part of the sphere, is called as a spherical wavefront. Wavefronts for diverging beam of light is as shown. This is the wavefront, the wave normal, and we know wavefronts for converging beam of light is also possible when lens is used. Wave normal. A normal or a perpendicular drawn to the surface of a wavefront at any point in the direction of propagation of light is called wave normal. The wave normal gives the direction of propagation of light. The direction of wave normal is called as the ray of light. The rays of light for spherical waves are diverging in nature. The rays of light for plane wavefronts are parallel in nature. The rays of light of cylindrical wavefront is cross-sectionally radial, which we are going to see in the next slide. This is a spherical wavefront. Rays are emerging from point O. These are the wavelets giving out secondary wavefront. It goes on increasing as the distance from O goes on increasing and the radii goes on increasing. And when the distance is quite a large, the radius becomes so large for a given area, the wavefronts look almost plane. So they become the plane wavefronts. So plane wavefronts, a wave emerging from the point source of light an infinite distance, that is at a very large distance, is called plane wavefront. Plane wavefront can be obtained by keeping point source of light at the focus of a convex lens. Example, light from the sun rays reaches the earth in the form of plane wavefronts. Now let us take a cylinder. So it goes on, these are the wave normals. These are the wave fronts. So what is a cylindrical wavefront then? A wavefront originating from a linear source. That linear source is very important. Linear source of light is called cylindrical wavefront. Source of light in the form of long narrow slit gives rise to cylindrical wavefronts. Huygens principle. Every point on wavefront acts as secondary source of light, emitting wavelets in all directions. The intensity of the secondary wavelets is maximum in the forward direction, whereas its intensity is a minimum or zero in the backward direction. The envelope or the common tangent drawn to all the secondary wavelets gives the position of the new wavefront at that instant. So that's a spherical wavefront again. These are the wavelets, the wavefronts, and that's the plane wavefront. These are the wavelets. So we have the spherical wavefront with a point source of light, wavefront at time t is equal to zero, which emerge gives out wavelets and act as secondary sources. And the secondary sources, a tangent is drawn along all of them and that gives the secondary wavelets. This is the wavefront at time capital T. Now let's see the distance. The distance of or the radius of one wavelet is V into T, velocity into the time. Similarly, for a plane wavefront, we have got these as the wavelets. Again, the radius is CT. So these are the secondary wavelets. That's the secondary wavefront. And the radius is V into T, the velocity into time. So that's it for today. Thank you. We will be continuing next time.